Good morning. We'd like to welcome you again to the Trinity Baptist Church in Westfield, North Carolina. If you don't have a church to attend or you're looking for a church to attend, we'd love to invite you to come and be with us in any and all of our services. Sunday morning services start at 10 o'clock. We have Sunday school preaching at 11. Sunday nights at 6 o'clock p.m. Wednesday nights at 7 o'clock p.m. We also have an FM transmitter for those that are unable to come in and be with us on the inside of the church. They can tune their radio to 92.9, come to the church, sit in the parking lot, and listen to the service. Maybe they don't feel like coming in, but they want to come. Or maybe they're afraid they're going to give somebody something, possibly. So they might stay in their vehicle and tune to the radio and listen from the parking lot. But boy, we're glad to have them with us. Amen. And it's good to have you with us this morning. I trust that the service today, the short 10 minutes with the pastor service, will be a blessing to you. Let me give you our physical address real quick, like, if you'd ever want to come and visit with us at Trinity Baptist Church. We're located at 1233 Collinstown Road in the Asbury section of Westfield, North Carolina. Now, if you punch it in your GPS, just punch in 1233 Collinstown, that's one word, Collinstown Road, Westfield. One word again, Westfield, North Carolina. And it would get you right here to the church. Be taking that good old authorized King James Bible this morning and turning with us to the book of Hebrews chapter number 12. Hebrews chapter number 12 while you're turning. And right before we pray, I want to make an announcement. Don't forget now that before long, we're going to be having our revival services starting on April the 4th on that Sunday morning. Easter Sunday morning, we'll be starting our revival service at 11 a.m., and we are looking forward to that. Amen. Looking forward to that. Brother Brent Rochester and his family will be with us. They're missionaries, and they're missionaries out working out of our church, and they're going to be with us Easter Sunday morning at 11 a.m. Brother Brent will preach, Lord willing, and they'll be singing, and then we won't have a Sunday night service on Easter, but Monday through Wednesday of that same week, we will be having revival services. Brother Brent will be preaching. They'll be singing 7 o'clock each night. So keep that in mind. We'd love for you to come if you can. And if you can't, please pray for us. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we love you this morning. We thank you for the opportunity of being able to have this 10 minutes with the pastor video. I hope it's a blessing to folk. And Lord, if it is, we'll give you the glory and honor for it because we can't do it without you. I pray for the lost that they'll get saved. Those that's backslid, they'll get right with you. God, I pray that you just help us as we look at your word today to be encouraged. I pray for all the services that are going on today where the word of God's preached, God, that you'd bless them in a great, great way. Just meet the need, Heavenly Father. Bless every man of God that'll be standing to preach. And Lord, I just pray you'd bless our services this morning, starting at 10 there at the church, and help us to do your will. And we'll praise you for all you do. I pray for our country, our leaders. God, we need revival. God's people, we need revival. And Lord, I pray for lost sinners that they'll get saved. And bless those in authority that they'll get saved. If they're not, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hebrews chapter number 12. We finished up verse 11 this past Sunday morning. We've been preaching through the book of Hebrews chapter 11 and chapter 12. We're in chapter 12 and we looked at verse 11 last week. And let's read that. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 12, verse number 11, "Now no chastening for the present seemeth to be joyous, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward, it yieldeth the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby." So there is a point to chastisement. There is a benefit to chastisement, thank God. It yieldeth the peaceable fruit of righteousness in our lives. If we're saved by the grace of God, the Holy Spirit of God lives within us. And when we sin, when we stray, when we do wrong, he convicts our heart. He chastens us. He shows us what we need to do and how we need to do it. He puts us under conviction. And that's not joyous at the moment. It's grievous. But it's going to yield something that's really, really good. And that's the peaceable fruit of righteousness. He said, "Unto those that are exercised thereby." Now, verse 12, "Wherefore, because of all that's been said," think about this, "because of all that's been said," and I can't go over everything that's been said, but we've been reminded that we're surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. We've been reminded in chapter 12 that we need to lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us. We need to run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. Amen. We've been reminded we need to consider the Lord so we won't faint, be wearied and faint in our mind. We need to realize that we've not went through nothing but what the Lord went through. The writer is trying to tell us, I believe the Apostle Paul, he's trying to tell us that we need to go on for God. Amen. Live for Jesus. And if we don't, he reminds us that we will be chastened. He talks about that starting in verse number 5 down through verse number 11. So wherefore, all these things that we've been encouraged in and told that we should do, amen, and what we should realize about the chastening, he says in verse 12, wherefore lift up the hands which hang down and the feeble knees, amen, and make straight paths for your feet. Straight path. Hey, we're to walk in the straight and the narrow way, amen. Make straight paths for your feet. Why? Lest that which is lame be turned out of the way, but let it rather be healed. Follow peace with all men. Now let me go back to verse number 12 for just a moment this morning. I like that. Wherefore lift up the hands which hang down and the feeble knees. Wherefore, when we realize these things, let's get at it, amen, with the help of the Lord. If we've not been, let's say, Lord, I realize my life has not been of much use to you. And Lord, I want my life to be of use to you. I want to lift up the feeble hands, amen. I like that. And the feeble knees, and make straight paths for your feet. Let's live for God, amen. Lest that which is lame be turned out of the way. Well, let it rather be healed. I don't want to be turned out of the way. I'd rather be healed and go on for God and do what God had me to do. Then he says in verse 14 this morning, he says, follow peace with all men. Follow peace with all men. And holiness. That's what it says. Without which no man shall see the Lord. This is not talking about working to be saved. This is talking about what we need to do. We need to follow peace with all men and holiness. Without which no man shall see the Lord. If we want people to see the Lord in our lives, then we're going to have to get serious about this thing. I told him at church recently, I said, listen, you're never going to be faithful until you make it a priority. And that's a fact. People will never be faithful to God, faithful to their local church, faithful to their job, faithful to their spouse, faithful to their children. They'll never be faithful to those things until they or we make it a priority. So follow peace with all men. Amen. Follow peace. Listen. And holiness. Follow peace with all men. Follow holiness, he says. Without which no man shall see the Lord. I want people to see God in my life. I want people to see that I'm saved. I want people to see the Lord in my life. Matthew 5:16 says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Jesus said, let your light so shine before men. Before men. Amen. Well, verse 14 says, follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. And then verse 15 this morning says, looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness spring up, trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. I believe this goes right along with what it said in verse number 14. Follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. And then looking diligently, be careful, amen. Be diligent in our walk. Be diligent in our talk. Try to be diligent in our lives. Looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God. Lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you. We better watch that bitterness. You and I better watch that bitterness. Don't get bitter. Stay sweet, amen. Follow peace with all men and holiness. And listen, we don't want that root of bitterness, verse 15 says, to spring up and trouble us, and not only trouble us, but he says many be defiled. If you're bitter, if I'm bitter, and we have an old bitter attitude, it's gonna rub off on other people. Amen? It's going to cause them to be that way. Some of them ain't going to be around us. So let's follow peace with all men. Let's realize we have a purpose. My purpose is to exalt the Lord. Now, I have a responsibility as a husband, as a parent, as a grandparent, as a pastor, as a Christian. But listen, I have a responsibility to, number one, please the Lord. And if I do that, I can please him in these other areas we just mentioned. Watch out for that old bitterness. Boy, it'll mess you up. You say, preacher, I'm full of it. Won't you confess it as sin to God and get right with the Lord? If you don't know Jesus this morning, why don't you repent of your sin and call on the Lord and ask God to save you? God's able to save you. He loves you. He wants to save you. Brother, sister, he wants us to live for him. He wants to be number one. And by the way, he's deserving of being number one. Father, we thank you for the privilege to be able to have this 10 minutes with the pastor this morning. I pray that God, you'd stir our hearts, help us to live for you. And we'll praise you for all you do for us. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Thank you for viewing this morning. I hope it's been a blessing to you with the help of the Lord. And until next week, next Sunday morning, we pray that God bless you really good. Amen.